The one thing that I want to register, the business plan is basically focused on particular on Khayelitsha, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And as we have seen our office, you know, we don't have resources, you know what I mean? We don't have even telecommunication, but the struggle is based here in Khayelitsha, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And so we are trying, we are pleading that at least was gone are the days of political parties, you know what I mean? The social movement is mushrooming in South Africa, day by day, in all the communities, because people are aware. People are aware because people are coming from the very, very, very dark phase, you know what I mean? So they knew what it meant to vote, what it meant for the democratic phase, and so on, you know what I mean? And the social transformation, you know what I mean? But now, today, it means that it's a capitalist agenda, you know what I mean? Of more like enriching those who are rich and the poorers getting poor and poor. You know what I mean? As we have seen, we have been in the meeting, you know what I mean? There are elderly people who are pensioners. We're not fighting anybody, you know what I mean? But at least the government at least should be able to cater and be able to meet the poor, half part, you know what I mean? This is a democratic government. And democratic government cannot arrest people when they are fighting for the basic human rights. You know what I mean?
Yes.
And right now, we don't have places to stay. You know what I mean?
Yes.
And how can you be banned? People were banned during the apartheid era. You know what I mean? During the apartheid government, how can you be banned? And now you can't go. I don't have a place right now to sleep. I don't know where I'm going to sleep tonight. You know what I mean? I've never murdered, I've never raped, I've never robbed a bank, I've done nothing. You know what I mean? Minister was here. Minister couldn't speak to the people because he knows that he's having a capitalist agenda. You know what I mean? A profit-making agenda, you know what I mean? Against the poor. You know what I mean? So people are aware, people are not stupid, people can think, people can decide. Let the people do that. You know what I mean? So you can't be like thinking that because you are a die person and then, you are thinking that people are stupid, you know what I mean? So what we're trying to say, man, at least right now, I think by next week on Monday, I think there will be, because we don't have resources, we are unable even to take our comrades out, because the agenda of the government now is to arrest us. The agenda is to arrest us.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Just an arrest without addressing the problem. And there's nobody knows why the police are involved.
Yeah.
You know? Why the police are involved in the bank issue. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
The banks must come and talk to their clients. You know what I mean? Like what we've done, what have happened. Other banks have managed to withdraw the arrears. You know what I mean? Completely from 120,000 to 18,000. So why the other banks cannot do that? You know what I mean? This is the agenda of the people and the banks, not the police. And the agenda now that is being used by the government is to arrest people. And in particular at night, innocent people, unarmed civilians, you know,
yeah,
they are being like victimized like by our own democratic government.
The way you mentioned, I'm not trust, but support is for now also live to his big conditions.
What are your bail conditions? Yeah.
My bail condition is not to attend any meeting, not to move out of the magistrate district of Khayelitsha without reporting to the investigating officer, which is the person in charge of the case, who will deny myself being going outside. You know what I mean? And also to sign 3 times a week, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Not to be part of any gathering, not to refrain from anybody that has been evicted in the community. I don't know how is it going to be practical, because everybody is being evicted, you know what I mean? So
yeah,
if they are saying that we must refrain, we mustn't communicate with people that are being evicted, it means that I mustn't communicate with everybody.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And that is state of emergency. That is an apartheid government that have imposed such serious act. You know what I mean? So I can't understand. Now we don't have places. We can't move around. You know what I mean? It's myself and Funky and basically and other comrades. But other comrades, they are safe because they can sign and still sleep in their houses with their families. You know what I mean? But with us, we don't know. You know, as if who have robbed a bank or who have killed and murdered the police. You know what I mean? Somebody, we don't know why.
Somebody said that the reason they first approached you was because you were interviewed on ETV or something?
Of course.
What happened?
Of course.
Could you explain that?
No, what happened when they interviewed me on ETV is because there was... they confiscated one pensioner's goods or furniture, you know what I mean, in 19th section around the area. I think we have moved around the area precisely because she's owing 800 rand of basic services that we've been promised. You know, we're promised free basic services by the democratic government, an ANC government, you know what I mean? So all of a sudden, if one is unable like to afford, you know, to pay for basic services, water, you know, they are privatizing water, you know what I mean? So if one is unable to pay that, you know, so one would be confiscated his good furniture, you know, everything in the house, like techniques, lounge suits, videos, TVs and everything. They will take that, you know, they are privatizing everything. You know, water is a natural resource, you know what I mean? So nobody can survive without water, you know what I mean? If they privatize that, it means those who are rich can be able to afford water. And without water, you cannot survive. You know what I mean? So that's capitalism. It's survival of the fittest. Those who are rich can afford. Those who are poor cannot afford. It means whilst we don't have jobs, and those who are unemployed, those who are like pensioners, cannot afford water. You know, this is exactly what is taking place. And now we are victims. And
if I can just say something,
we don't know
without you televising. If you can just...
I'm going to do this, but I just want to register something. Could you please, just be able to speed up and forward our business plan?
Yes.
And I'm not sure how can you get your staff in terms of following
it.
Up. You gave it
yeah,
to me.
I gave it to you.
Never.
You know, and Anna has myself. Yeah.
For Anna, I have... Okay,
yeah,
I can
and
only
Francois and everybody.
And Francois and everybody. Oh, I can always get them to them, you know.
Yeah.
So that we can be able, man, as you have seen our office and the people are illiterate, we need capacity building workshops, like technical skills, computer programs, because our people are still illiterate.
Yes.
Because they've been disadvantaged education. You know what I mean? The very same people that are being evicted today are the people that have been affected, you know, by the very same gutter education, who never went to school. You know, you can see all the people that were there. They never went to school. They, all of them are having 6 and 5 and so on. You know what I mean? So they have been denied deliberately by the apartheid government. You know, and now the very same people without jobs, without education, without houses, unemployed, you know what I mean? They are being drained to the drain. You know what I mean? So, I mean, comrades, man, I'm hoping that at least, sooner or later we'll be communicating.
And your court case is April 16th?
The first case is on the 18th of April when we went to the MEC of Housing.
Uh-huh.
Machala Angana for subsidy and the purchase of land.
Sorry, may I greet you?
Okay.
This is Amek's mother.
Oh my gosh.
I've seen you there, but I couldn't talk to
hello,
you.
Hello, hello.
Right, glad to see you here. Eh?
You have a brave son.
So, I mean, the next case is on the 18th of next month, and then the other one is on March, and the other one is on April. So, we don't have money to pay those lawyers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, we're struggling.
And
it means if we are unable to afford those lawyers, it means we have to stay in prison.
Yes.
You know, and your presence here, we hope at least we'll be able to assist the campaign.
We can.
What is this whole thing? Is police? Just go slow.
Yeah, this whole thing.
Okay, just go not too noticeably slow. And at the very end is where the anti-riot thing is.
Yara.
What's it called?
Yara.
Yara?
Nayala.
Yala?
Nayala.
Nayala. Okay, stop. Go slow. No, it's up at the very end. Okay, here it is. Now slow. Okay. So. That's the police, huh?
These people has got no services here.
No electricity, no nothing.
That's why they don't worry now, but they're gonna come for it.
Wow.
You are most probably going to.